A warm welcome to the weekly briefings with me, Chandni. I'm here to give you a quick sneak peek of what is happening in the world of women's cricket. Stay with me just for 5 minutes and you will know all the top news from last week. So here we go. Mithali Raj believes India is on track with World Cup preparations. All talk in cricket is now about the World Cup 2022, which will be played in New Zealand next March. This time around, there are many expectations from our Indian girls. And according to our skipper, Mithali Raj, the team too is well prepared to give its best. Our girls have had a busy year playing top teams like South Africa at home and touring England and Australia. Now, before the big event starts, India will also play a series against New Zealand. Talking about India's performance overseas at an event for the Indian Deaf Cricket Association in Delhi, Mithali Raj said, and I quote, "When you play against a strong team in its backyard, you try to give it your best. Though we lost the series, the matches were very close. We scored 270 and chased 270 odd. If we can do that consistently, we will be among the best sides in the world." Apart from that, Indian players are also part of overseas tours and franchisee leagues, which gains them exposure and experience. So the team seems to be prepared mentally and physically. As for all of us fans, we too have faith and are waiting for the win. Senior One Day Challenger Trophy. Like I promised last week, it is time to talk about the Senior Challenger Trophy. We begin with the first day where India A lost to India B. Even though India A skipper Yastika Bhatia scored an 81, India B comfortably won the match. Palak Patel was the top scorer with 79, followed by Harleen Deol, 62 runs. As for the bowlers, Chandu V picked up a 3 for 30. Next, the strongest team on paper, India D proved their worth by bowling out India C within 50 overs, thanks to Kanika Ahuja's 4-wicket haul and Pooja Vastrakar and S. Meghna's half centuries. On the next day, India A played India C, wherein Team A bowled Team C out for 205 runs within 49 overs and chased the target in 46 overs. All-rounder Sneha Rana was the star of the match with 59 runs and a 3 for 32. In the other match, S. Meghna's fiery century and Pooja Vastrakar's 3-wicket haul saw India D beat India B by 46 runs. So having won 2 matches, India D are the favourites of the tournament. ECB to double salaries for the 2022 edition of the 100. The England and Wales Cricket Board has delivered on a promise which was made after the success of the inaugural of the 100 by announcing an increase in the salaries for the players. According to the numbers released by the ECB at the end of the tournament this year, close to 270 fans attended the women's matches, which is a record-breaking feat. Apart from that, 1.4 million viewers tuned in for the final, while over 17,000 attended the final, which was played at the Lords. So it is no rocket science to know that the response for this tournament has been spectacular. Talking about numbers, ESPN Cricket4 reported that the highest paid player in the next women edition will earn £31,000 instead of £15,000. The lowest paid player will receive £7,500 instead of £3,600. All 8 teams will now have a salary purse of £250,000, which is a significant increase from the £120, which was allotted last season. So overall, there's been a jump of 108% for the female cricketers. Charlie Dean and Christy Gordon are part of England's pre-Ashes training camp. The Women's Ashes will be played down under in January next year, with England hoping to get its hands back on the trophy after 2014. England have a training squad practicing in Oman, and surprise inclusions in this squad are non-contracted players Charlie Dean, Maya Bouchier and Christy Gordon. Off-spinner Charlie Dean and all-rounder Maya Bouchier both made their international debut against New Zealand this year. Dean was impressive, taking 10 wickets from 5 matches at an average of 19 and a best of 4 for 36. Christy Gordon made heads turn during the T20 World Cup in 2018. Apart from this, all the players in the training camp are centrally contracted players. CSE announces a 2-week national camp. Like I said, everyone's eyeing the Cricket World Cup 2022, and each cricket association wants to make sure that the players are in good form for the global series. Therefore, Cricket South Africa too have announced a 2-week national camp, but a methodical one, making sure that it has taken all precautions amidst the new COVID-19 variant. According to the updates received, the camp will be organized in a biosecure environment. Head coach Hilton Moreen said that the entire squad needs to touch base in one place in order to continue the competitive edge it has had throughout the year. Ahead of the Global Series, South Africa will also be playing the West Indies in January. Before I take off, I have one sad but inspiring news. The oldest test cricketer from England, Eileen Ash, passes away at 110 years. Ash made her debut against Australia before the Second World War in 1937. She played 7 tests in all, taking 10 wickets, including best figures of 3 for 35 against Australia. After serving for UK's intelligence service, MI6, during the World War, Ash played her last test in 1949 against New Zealand in Auckland. Well, what an interesting life she must have had. That is all I have for this week. Do drop in your thoughts and comments. I will see you next week. Till then, be happy, think positive, and stay safe.